and some more time will take place. This is the second stage of the action of the planets. That is, the planets suggest to you as well-wishers. The first stage is like police officers. The second stage is like the well-wishers. And in the third stage, planets begin to work as friends. That is, when we resisted temptation, when we have learned how to follow the advice of the planets by simply understanding our environment every day, every hour and every minute, we can know how to follow the advice of the planets.
Then,
because the planets place us in such an environment as is useful for our future evolution, and they make it possible for good things to occur. They show many obstacles whenever our mind is in the wrong direction. If we care to know the will of the planets and the advice of the planets by understanding the environment and the persons around us every hour and every minute, then the planets begin to work as our friends. That is, they have many good things to make a gift to us. Until then, they cannot make any gift to us because we are not in a position to accept if they give. Now, when we can resist temptation, when we can understand the will of the planets and follow it in action, then the planets have many things to give to us. All the powers of the mind and the will that are existing under the folds of our evolution, they will be opened to us and we will be allowed into the innermost secrets of our consciousness, and we will be placed under high opportunities. Great opportunities will be thrown before us. Only when the planets are sure, we do not use these opportunities for ourselves at all. Until then, we suffer from poverty. Sometimes it may be poverty of money, sometimes poverty of intelligence, sometimes poverty of courage, sometimes poverty of self-confidence. So the planets will keep us under check and control with the poverty of something. This is true as far as the planets know. This is true as far as the planets understand that we have a tendency to use opportunities for ourselves. This is the intricate mechanism with which the planets work. They take our psychological mechanism as their laboratory, and they always work as a purificatory process. This is the first one and two steps. When we have entered the third step, that is when the planets understood that we have no tendency to use anything to ourselves, then the planets have many gifts to give us, many presentations to do us. They may allow you to know the future, either of yourself or of others, or they can give you the power to control the thoughts of others, or the power to command thousands of people. All these things will be given to you. From the moment they know that you do not want to use any one of these things for yourself, in such a horoscope, it is very, very difficult to predict, because there will be no incidents occurring according to the horoscope. If you take the horoscope to the astrologer, he can never predict anything at all. Even the death he cannot predict, because the span of life of such a person is always variable, whereas the span of the lowest person is clearly fits, because he misbehaves with everything. The planets know his tendencies, and when it has become unbearable for the inner consciousness to live in that body, then the planets stimulate his mind into such an action that he will eat or drink enough to kill himself. So, span of life can be clearly understood in the man of the lowest evolution. But in the horoscope of a spiritual man, span of life is always variable. It can never be fixed by even the planets, because the planets may continue the lease of life for some time more.
Die Zeitspanne länger andauern lassen.
Were to be done through him, to his neighbors. So, if a spiritual purpose was there for him, then he may be allowed to live for 6 or 7 years more. That is what has happened in the case of Madame Blavatsky. You know that his span was finished in the middle of her writing the Secret Doctrine. And she was very, very sick. And one night she died. The doctors also came and saw that she died. And after a few minutes they found her once again living. And 4 years she lived after and completed the Secret Doctrine and then died. In the meanwhile, when she was unconscious, the masters called her out from her body. The masters called her out from her body and asked her, "Do you want to continue in this body and complete the work? It means a great suffering to you. Or do you want to leave the body and have, do you want to leave the body and have some rest?" Because for a spiritualist, leaving the body is only a little rest. Sir. Because the work continues in the next birth. But for all those who believe that death is the end, death is a big incident. For those who know spiritualism, death is not at all an incident. It is like 1 or 2 hours taking rest in a room. Then she answered, "I can bear the inconvenience of this body, but I prefer to complete the work and go away if possible." So in such horoscopes, if the astrologer sees the horoscope, and if you ask what is the probable span of this person, he may make his own blind calculations and give you some date which is bound to fail. You know that astrologers killed great people many times before they died. Sometimes in the newspapers also, they publish the death date of some great people. But many times they have to revise the date and publish once again, and they have to kill the same person 3 or 4 times. So that is the case in the horoscopes of higher births. So, to read such horoscopes, the ordinary methods of astrology is not enough. You know how Master Jwalkul warns us about the esoteric astrology, which is quite different from the popular astrology. And in many places, he advises us to get into the logic of esoteric astrology and judge the horoscope according to the higher principles of astrology. This method will give you one of the higher methods of astrology, because it is used for spiritual horoscopes. That is why I wanted to introduce this method to you. Now, we will go into the Aquarius, the study of the Aquarius sign. Aquarius, the most sacred sign of the zodiac, is the 4th of the fixed signs and the 3rd of air triplicity. Because the fixed signs are Taurus.
Fixed sign.
Fixed.
Yeah, yeah.
Fixed.
Yeah.
The fixed signs are Taurus, Leo, Scorpio and Aquarius. So when counted from Aries, Aquarius is the fourth of the fixed sign. And the Aries signs are Gemini, Libra and Aquarius. The Aquarius is the third of the Aries triplicity. It represents the establishment of man in the fourth plane and in the third state of air. Third state of air. That is the spiritual air. This sentence requires explanation. Establish the stable signs indicate the establishment of consciousness. They indicate establishment of the consciousness. There are, we'll use this tomorrow.
Sure.
There are three aspects to our consciousness called dynamism, inertia and poise. We have three modes of expression for the consciousness. Aries indicates dynamism, Taurus indicates inertia and Gemini indicates poise. Equilibrium.
Yeah.
Equilibrium. Again, the next one, Cancer indicates dynamism, Leo indicates inertia, Virgo indicates poise, Libra indicates dynamism, Scorpio indicates inertia, Sagittarius poise, Capricorn dynamism, Aquarius inertia and Pisces. So we have the four modes of consciousness and expressed in three modalities. Now we have to understand each of these. The first one causes change. The second one causes stability. The third one causes adjustment. This succession always takes place in the consciousness of everyone. So, whenever there is an incident around us, there is a change of consciousness. And then we will react to the change. So, we will create another change.
Kreieren.
That necessitates changes in the daily routine. Automatically, it will be very inconvenient because we will be very, very busy with all the changes we do. And then we begin to adjust. We want to make some leisure time to avoid some activity, to stand, to pause and think. This causes a monotony in the daily routine. And then our mind reacts to the monotony. And then there will be the necessity to adjust between activity and monotony. And we will find out the innermost consciousness of us, which is neither activity nor monotony, but which is continuity. Like thus, these three will be alternating in succession. That is why we find the same order in the zodiac. And our consciousness will be traveling in all these three successions. 1, 2, 3 states. In these three states it will be traveling. Again a second time it travels. And then again a third time it travels. And again a fourth time it travels. It goes on establishing itself into triangles arranged in four-sided figures until all the four triangles are adjusted into one square like this. So we have the first stage in our evolution, the lowest stage, the second stage, the third stage and the fourth stage as the four stages of our evolution, and the establishment in four layers of consciousness. The first layer of consciousness is what we know as our consciousness. That is that which is working now. It is what we call objectivity. The second stage is called sleep. The third stage is called dream. The fourth stage is called yogic stage. Evolution makes us travel through these four stages until we establish in the fourth stage. But the succession of stages is a bit different. When we are undergoing the evolution of the mineral kingdom, we will experience the sleep-like stage. And then after we enter into the plant kingdom, we live a consciousness of dreamlike stage. And when we enter into the animal kingdom, we will get into the awakened stage. That is, we will awaken into mind and senses. Previously, there was no mind and senses. Though there was consciousness. The plant has consciousness, but it has no mind or senses. Because it has no apparatus for the mind and the senses. There should be the separation of brain cells if the mind wants to get separated and operate. In the plant kingdom, there is no separate brain cells. So the mind is not separated from the existence. There will be only sensations and feelings and no sense organs or senses and thought. Therefore, from the dream to the animal kingdom, we are awakened. Yeah. The moment we enter into the animal kingdom, brain cells are separated from the other cells. And gradually, the vertebral column will be prepared. And the nervous system is prepared. With the help of the brain cells and the nervous system, we will awaken into mind. That is the third stage of our evolution, the evolution of the animal kingdom. And in the fourth stage, we become self-conscious. In the animal kingdom, we can become conscious of anything except ourselves. We can be conscious of our house, environment, and our master. Suppose we were in the stage of a cow or a dog. We can recognize our master and we can return to master's house daily. We can know all these things. We can feel pain also, but we are not self-conscious. We are not conscious that we are existing. But when we enter into the human kingdom, we become self-conscious. Not that immediately we will become self-conscious, but we will begin to become self-conscious. And it takes many births until we become fully conscious of ourselves. That means we have to become self-conscious of all the seven planes of our existence, and we should be conscious of our soul existence. We should understand what group life is. Then we will understand that there is no separate existence, but everyone is one with the total humanity. We know that we cannot be separated. This change takes place in the fourth stage. So these four stages are marked by the four fixed signs in the zodiac. Marked by.
Ankit.
So even after the human birth, these four stages of consciousness are in us. While we are sleeping, while we are dreaming, and when we are daily awakened from our sleep, we have the experience of the three previous stages of consciousness. And even after awakened, we may be working our daily routine in the house or office, but we are not fully conscious of our existence. We may be conscious of our office and our home. We may be conscious of our husband, wife or children and the daily routine.
Yeah.
But that is not self-consciousness, fully awakened. That is what is called the routine activity that never requires our consciousness, because our routine activity drives us from incident to incident in the day. For example, when it is morning, we get up. When it is hunger, we eat.
Yeah.
When we have thirst, we drink. When we are tired, we sleep.
Yeah.
When it is time to go to office, we run to office. This is only routine. One incident is driving us into the next incident. It is only a mechanical activity of our intelligence in which we need not be present fully.
Present.
So, even though we are awakened, we may not be self-conscious. We have to continue the human evolution until we become fully self-conscious. So, all the human beings on this earth are having four layers of consciousness. The Taurus layer of consciousness, the Leo layer of consciousness, the Scorpio layer of consciousness, and the Aquarian layer of consciousness. So, Aquarius indicates the fourth or the last layer of consciousness. That is the spiritual layer of consciousness. It is also interesting to know that we are experiencing the fourth layer of consciousness also in our daily routine sometimes. But it is for us to understand that level of consciousness, know it with our experience, and have a mastery over that state of consciousness, and practice to live in that consciousness more and more time until we totally live in that layer of consciousness. The fourth stage of consciousness, which we call the yogic stage, can be given examples. During that stage of consciousness, your mind is not working, your senses are not working, but you are working fully conscious. The first two things we can understand: when your mind is not working,
nicht am Arbeiten,
and your senses are not working, we can understand that it is sleep. Whenever we are in sleep, the mind and the senses are not working. But here in the fourth stage, it is true that the mind and the senses are not working, but it is also true that you are fully conscious and you are working. You are working. Even though you are opening your eyes, the eyes do not see. The mind does not allow the eyes to see in that state of consciousness. For example, all this time there are those two wonderful things before your eyes, but your eyes are not seeing them and your mind is not allowing to see them. Such is the condition of the fourth stage of consciousness. You have not closed your eyes to those two things all this 1 hour, but the eyes never saw them and the mind never allowed to see them. This is an example of a part experience of the yogic stage. Sometimes you will be enjoying that stage fully also. For example, when you see an object, you should not remember the name of the object, the word watch should not come to your mind, but the watch, the object exists to you. The color does not exist to your mind, but yet the object exists. The shape does not exist to you, but yet the object exists. Similarly, around you, all these things exist. All these persons exist to you, but the names of these persons do not exist to you. The faces and their shapes do not exist to you. Their relationships with you do not exist to you. And your impression of each person does not exist to you. Everything exists to you without their name, shape, color, etc. And without your impression upon them, they exist to you. Even this you will be experiencing many times, but you might not have noticed it.